Hey there. If you're new to our channel, you can subscribe by hitting the leaf icon in the bottom right corner of the video. Click the bell icon to turn on notifications, and please be sure to like and comment below. An estimated 400 million people in the world are now living with diabetes. This equates to 1 in 11 adults. While type 1 diabetes is less common and is usually related to genetics, type 2 diabetes, once called adult-onset diabetes, is now so common it can impact children as young as age 5. Type 2 diabetes is most typically the result of poor diet and a lack of exercise. By 2040, the number of people suffering from type 2 diabetes across the globe could rise to more than 640 million. As the standard American diet, also referred to as the Western Pattern Diet, has spread across the world, people have increased their intake of fatty and processed foods. Now, more than two-thirds of Americans are overweight or obese. And according to diabetes.co.uk, obesity is believed to account for 80 to 85% of the risk of developing type 2 diabetes. Lack of exercise also increases the risk of developing diabetes. The less active a person is, the greater the risk of the disease. The World Health Organization notes that physical inactivity alone is estimated to cause 7% of the burden of type 2 diabetes in the European region. According to the American Diabetes Association, in 2015, more than 30 million Americans were diabetic, and more than 84 million adults were pre-diabetic. Dr. Eugene Chang told Everyday Health, "Over the past century, we've seen the incidence of chronic diseases go up dramatically in Western culture, and that's due to changes in our lifestyle, diet, and environment. The symptoms of type 2 diabetes vary." Diabetes UK says, "A lot of people don't get any symptoms or they don't notice them. Some people don't think the symptoms are important, so don't ask for help." It adds, "This means that people live with type 2 diabetes for up to 10 years before being diagnosed." The health consequences of diabetes can be serious. It can lead to nerve damage, resulting in the loss of feeling in the limbs, as well as kidney damage and eye damage, with the potential risk of blindness. It can also potentially increase the risk of heart disease, stroke, sleep apnea, and Alzheimer's disease. But diabetes may be managed effectively with a vegan diet. By eating a healthy vegan diet low in cholesterol and saturated fat, but balanced enough to include fiber and protein, blood glucose levels can be made easier to control, says diabetes.co.uk. This type of diet, particularly when combined with exercise, can help to lower blood glucose levels and better manage diabetes. A recent study of more than 2,000 young adults supports this point of view. For participants that increased the amount of fruits, vegetables, and nuts in their diet over the course of 20 years, the risk of developing type 2 diabetes was 60% lower than those who didn't. A study from the University of London also found that a plant-based diet can help to ease symptoms of depression, as well as other mental health issues, in type 2 diabetes sufferers. A critical analysis of more than 400 individuals with diabetes, aged in their mid-50s, revealed that physical and emotional quality of life improved after switching to a vegan diet. Lead author of the study, Anastasios Tumpanakis, said, "We would say that people with type 2 diabetes following a plant-based diet might be happier because, as the studies suggest, the majority found that through this eating pattern, they can have better control of their condition." Nerve pain was also less common in those following a plant-based diet. Those who remained on a non-vegan diet reported a loss of temperature control in their feet, suggesting that plant-based foods can help to slow progressive nerve damage in diabetes sufferers. Many medical experts believe that a healthy plant-based diet can go further than just managing type 2 diabetes.
Overall, the results suggest that a plant-based diet can improve overall quality of life, psychological well-being, and chronic diabetic neuropathy in people with type 2 diabetes without changes in food enjoyment and diet costs. So it's not more expensive, people don't dislike it, it just gets rid of a whole lot of physical and mental problems, psychological problems that people have.
It may also help to reverse the condition.
Now put that in the context of the fact that nutritional excellence has the ability to work better than drugs.
It can be reversed, something we've known since the 1970s. Now, we've known that, look, any weight loss can slow or even reverse diabetes.
In Slovakia, the natural food interaction diet, which promotes the consumption of plant-based whole foods, is undergoing trials at the National Institute for Diabetes and Endocrinology. The diet was developed after years of study on the interactions of chemicals within food. It may help to reverse type 2 diabetes without need for further medical intervention. Recommended meals on the diet include Weetabix, a whole grain wheat breakfast cereal with chia seeds and almond milk, and quinoa with dark green vegetables and pine nuts. The American College of Lifestyle Medicine recommends an online program that encourages diabetes sufferers to adopt a plant-based diet to help reverse the condition. And vegan physician Dr. Neil Barnard released a plant-based recipe book specifically for people who want to reverse type 2 diabetes.
In 2006, we published the first findings from a breakthrough study that was funded by NIH, where we did a head-to-head test of a conventional diabetes diet that reduced calories and asked the participants to count carbohydrate grams versus an experimental approach that used a totally vegan low-fat diet. And you know what happened? The vegan diet caused more weight loss, better blood sugar control, and it helped people to a surprising degree.
Barnard is the founding president of the Physicians Committee for Responsible Medicine. The committee is a nonprofit organization dedicated to the promotion of a plant-based diet and preventative medicine. Its members include 12,000 physicians. Barnard's book is helping to save lives. One diabetes sufferer told PCRM, "I've gone from 2,000 milligrams of metformin a day to now only 500 milligrams a day, and I'm still in progress. Thank you." Metformin is the first-line medication for the treatment of type 2 diabetes. One person said their wife was recommended the book by their doctor. "My wife's numbers that had been out of control for so long were finally predictable," he said. Another patient added simply, "Did it. It worked. Thanks." Weight has gone up and come back down, Barnard told Parade. Sugars that have gone up can go back down. Medication doses that have gone higher year by year can come down, as can cholesterol levels and blood pressure levels and medication used to treat them. Brooklyn's borough president Eric Adams says he reversed his diabetes with a plant-based diet. He was losing his eyesight and suffering from nerve damage in his hands and feet. He decided to take matters into his own hands and manage his condition with an active lifestyle and a healthy vegan diet.
"My eyesight cleared up when I changed my diet. In 3 months, all the nerve damage was gone, the ulcer was gone, all of those symptoms that I had associated with my diabetes disappeared."
Type 2 diabetes runs in his family. He told Everyday Health, "Imagine the excitement I have in watching my mother, who has been injecting herself with insulin since I was 2 years old, now hear me tell her that she can reverse her condition. I can't even express the emotions that are attached to that." Adams isn't the only public figure to improve his health with a vegan diet. Rapper will.i.am ditched meat and dairy in 2017. He lost weight, and his cholesterol and blood pressure levels improved.
"My high blood pressure was high, had high cholesterol. And since then, starting in December, you know, I changed what I eat. I have a plant-based diet. I work out."
He said, "The cholesterol is down as well, but it runs in my family, and diabetes. So I want to get it under control now, so I don't have to worry about it later on."
"I want to continue my veganism, working out, staying fit, getting gorilla ripped, you know what I'm saying? Get my gorilla muscles straight."
Kevin Smith has also claimed that following a vegan diet has improved his health. The filmmaker suffered a heart attack at the beginning of 2018. He then decided to ditch animal products and go vegan. He was told he needed to lose 50 pounds. He lost 17 pounds in just 9 days of eating plant-based foods.
"You're looking at me right now going like, Silent Bob telling me how to f***ing eat? Yes, believe it or not, man. Like, I'm not saying I'm an expert, but I've been through some stuff. And so now I can speak on the issue of men's health."
After a month of plant-based eating, Smith's doctor ran lab tests and said the results looked fantastic. The doctor reduced Smith's Lipitor cholesterol medication by half, because his levels had dropped so radically. Following the change, Smith's daughter, vegan model and actress Harley Quinn Smith, said her dad was thriving. He's doing really great. He's the healthiest he's ever been. He's vegan now, which is amazing.
Once he had his heart attack, I was absolutely not going to let him continue living his life without veganism being a part of it.
The American Diabetes Association recommends people eat plant-based whole foods like citrus, fruits, and berries. The group says a vegan diet rich in fresh fruits, vegetables, and plant-based proteins, including beans, grains, nuts, and seeds, can help to mitigate the onset and effects of type 2 diabetes. In its 2018 Standards of Medical Care and Diabetes, the ADA cites 35 studies pointing to the benefits of a plant-based diet, and also notes that doctors and nutritionists should always educate patients on lifestyle management. Diabetes.co.uk agrees. It states, "Many people instantly recoil at the idea of a vegan diet, but this attitude is gradually changing, particularly amongst people with diabetes. Can people with diabetes use a vegan diet to improve blood glucose control? Absolutely. By eating a healthy vegan diet low in cholesterol and saturated fat, but balanced enough to include fiber and protein, blood glucose levels can be made easier to control. This type of diet, particularly when combined with exercise, can help to lower blood glucose levels and better manage diabetes." The NHS has also recognized the benefits of a vegan diet for people with diabetes. It acknowledged a study that suggests a strong link between a whole foods plant-based diet and type 2 diabetes prevention in overweight adults. This high-level recognition represents the initial acceptance of the vegan diet in both the public sector and the scientific community. The research referred to by the NHS involved a 16-week randomized control experiment that placed 75 overweight men and women into two groups, one on a low-fat vegan diet, the intervention group, the other without change to their current diet, the control group. The intervention group showed improved function of their beta cells, in addition to a reduction in BMI and reportable visceral fat loss. The control group did not see significant results in either beta cell function or weight loss. The NHS applauded the research technique of the randomized trial, stating that it is the best way to assess the effectiveness of an intervention. It also conceded that a vegan diet tends to incorporate less fat and sugar than the typical Western diet, so the results are not particularly surprising. Consuming high amounts of sugar is commonly thought of as increasing the risk of diabetes, but according to experts appearing in the 2017 documentary What the Health, processed meat is also a risk factor.
Harvard researchers looked at 9 prospective studies, finding that just one serving of processed meat per day increased risk of developing diabetes by 51%. The link between eating meat and developing diabetes became undeniable.
It pulled this finding from a study conducted in August 2011 and published in the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition. Referencing a 2009 study, the filmmakers note that if a person eats meat,
today, with two-thirds of Americans being overweight, clearly there's a food issue. In the next 25 years, one out of every 3 Americans will have diabetes.
Diabetes, the arthritis, the heart disease, the dementia, the obesity, the cancers are affecting about 70% of deaths. All the data is that those 70% of deaths and morbidity are largely lifestyle related and preventable.
What do you think? Do you agree? Do you or anyone you know manage type 2 diabetes with a vegan lifestyle? Let us know in the comments below. Remember to subscribe and hit the notification bell. New videos every Tuesday and Friday.